Hi, I'm Daniel. Let's talk accounting. Today I'll show you how to set up and record JobKeeper payments in Xero. As always, check the description box for links. Please like this video if it helps you and subscribe and hit the bell for updates and future videos. Here we see Xero's checklist for getting ready for JobKeeper payments. This menu can be accessed from the dashboard by clicking on Payroll, Pay Employees, visit our Payroll support page. Today we'll focus on number 4 and 5. Briefly, number 1 is to calculate the turnover of your business to ensure that you're eligible. Xero supply a calculator to assist with this. Step 2 would be to enrol your business in the JobKeeper payment scheme with the ATO, and again Xero provide a handy link to the ATO website. Hopefully you've already set up single touch payroll, so let's have a look at step 4, enrolling employees for JobKeeper payments. Xero highlights the employees that are unlikely to be eligible, perhaps because of their start date, age, or other factors. Once you've identified the eligible employees, click Start JobKeeper. Select the JobKeeper fortnight for which you have made payments or will make payments for. If you're joining at the beginning of the scheme, be sure to select Fortnight 1. Xero provide a warning notice that this selection cannot be changed. Click Save for reporting. Repeat this step for the other nominated employees. Step 5 is to update your JobKeeper pay items to report correctly to the ATO. If you have already set up an allowance item for JobKeeper payments, such as in my previous video, you'll need to go into Settings, Payroll Settings, Pay Items, find the JobKeeper payment top-up allowance created earlier, click Edit. Change the type to JobKeeper Payment Top-Ups and click Save. Otherwise, you will simply use the JobKeeper Payment Top-Up allowance that Xero have added. To apply this allowance, click on Payroll, Employees. Update the payroll template for employees who are earning less than $1,500 per fortnight but need to have their wage topped up to this amount. Click on such an employee. Click on their pay template. Click Add Earnings Line, select the JobKeeper Payment Top-Up Allowance, click OK, and enter the top-up payment amount. Save, and repeat this process for any other employees who may need to have their pay topped up to the $1,500 amount. There is no need to follow this step for any employees who are already earning the $1,500 or above. Thank you for watching. Please like if this helped you. Click subscribe and hit the bell for future updates and videos.